It's a war that has taken place inside the heart and inside the mind of believers, that you could be somebody who is a believer in Christ and yet still struggle to gain victory over these things of self and sin and the silence of life. And nowhere in the New Testament does it say that if you live in right relationship with the Holy Spirit, only good things are going to happen to you. That's called the prosperity gospel, and it's fake. That yes, God is for us, and Paul goes on to say, if God is for us, then who could be against us? What could separate us from the love of God? Famine, hardship, persecution? But the reality is, in ending chapter 8 that way, he's saying, you could be in Christ, and there could be a victory and a hope that is yours. That does not take you out of, remove you from the stresses of life. The Holy Spirit says, I've come to take up residence so that whatever you walk through, not to take you out of the scenarios of life, but to walk with you through the scenarios of life, not only so that you could have hope and victory, but so that you can take that hope and victory to the world in which you live, who needs to see a different picture than what would naturally show up in front of them. That the Holy Spirit could be that still, small voice that says, I'm here. You don't necessarily know all the answers at this point, but I'm here. It might not seem like God's going to win inside of this situation, but I'm here. It looks like the devil's winning and everything on the outside is just falling apart, but I'm here and I'm with you and I'm not going anywhere. But we can get through this together.